The parotid gland contains normal intraparotid lymph nodes, and you will see normal intraparotid lymph nodes. Please don't call them lesions if they look like normal, non-enlarged nodes. These, however, are large masses, and they're very solid. And look at them, they're both in the superficial parotid, but posteriorly, they're both in the parotid tail. So the most common differential will be a Wharton's tumor, which can be multicentric, either unilateral or bilateral, in about 20%, and often associated with males, slightly more elderly, and with a history of smoking or irradiation. They are benign lesions, though. Now, ultrasound is very useful in the parotid. It's very accessible, especially the superficial lobe. So in this one, hypoechoic lesion, anechoic anteriorly with little internal debris, posterior acoustic enhancement, it's a cystic lesion. But look around the parotid next to it, all these little dots. That's too many for a single image. The background parotid is abnormal. Some that could be a node, and some are complex cystic, some indeterminate to tell, but they're very small. So this is a proteinaceous cyst in the parotid on a background of abnormal parotid glands bilaterally. You can see on the T2, the lesion that brought the patient to our attention, and the background of this multiple, very heterogeneous, sort of almost a polka dotty look to the parotid glands on both sides, and they look subjectively mildly enlarged. So this is a diffuse parotid process. So we've got to think of other things. On the post-contrast study, this was internally proteinaceous content we saw on the T1, so it's not necessarily enhancing. And again, some of these don't enhance, or some are complex little cysts. This ended up being the lymphoepithelial cysts of HIV, which often get associated, and we see as almost like a reactive change in the parotid glands. But other diffuse diseases that can affect the parotid glands include things like your Sjogren's, your sarcoidosis. Don't forget, it's got lymph nodes as a normal structure, so lymphoma will affect the parotid glands just as much as it affects other nodes in the cervical chain. And other things like chronic duct disease, ductal calculi, sialectasis. With chronic changes, you can get duct dilatation and little cystic areas forming in the parotid gland. So this is a CT, and again, you get the impression the parotid glands look abnormal. They're kind of indistinct in their margins. The fat is very stranded. You can see that's all very dirty-looking fat. But again, bilateral symmetrical. And as you come down, you get the impression, look, are the nodes normal or abnormal? There's lots of little prominent nodes. That's a prominent node. They're too easy to find. And I have a rule, if a junior registrar finds you nodes too easily, they're abnormal. This ended up being a sarcoidosis. But again, you can't tell short of FNAing the patient. Because, you know, lymphoma can look like this. Sometimes a Sjogren's disease can look like this, although typically more cystic. All we can do is indicate that, you know, there's a generalized process and, you know, we can offer FNA.